Down to the pier where the sun will come out. Having 1979, I was ordained to the parish of Whitley Bay in the Diocese of Newcastle near Tynemouth. The parish community there included a number of merchant seamen and their families, and I quickly came to know them and the privilege and the cost of giving your life to the sea as they did, and as so many of you clearly. Also in the Diocese of Newcastle, there was Lindisfarne, a holy island. And you will probably know that this place, the home of St. Cuthbert and of monks through the ages, is cut off by the tide. Every time the tide comes in, it becomes an island indeed. But then at low tide, you can drive to and fro across a causeway. Beside the causeway, there lived the farmer. And this man decided he would make an investment in his farming equipment. And so he bought a schnorkel for the exhaust of his tractor, so that he could safely drive his tractor into 3 or 4 or 5 feet of water. He did this for a shrewd commercial reason. Each year, without fail, a number of people would come across the causeway at low tide, find themselves cut off by the tide as it came in, and would not believe that the sea could possibly get in their way, so they would drive straight in. A couple of minutes later, their car would stall, they themselves would splutter back to the island, and the farmer would come out and offer to tow in their car for a couple of £100. That schnorkel was a great investment, shrewdly bought, because that farmer knew that in this generation, there are people who do not know the strength of the sea. As far as I know, he's still there, and I would be amazed if he's not still in business. You must treat nature with respect, otherwise you're in trouble. They certainly understood that in the days of the Bible. Dame Lorna read to us an extract from the Acts of the Apostles, the missionary journeys of St. Paul, which usually involved sailing across the Mediterranean with its infamous ability to produce storms out of nowhere. Of course, in those days, there was no GPS. There was no way that you could calculate the longitude. All you could do was hope for the best and keep testing the depth of the water. And we heard the story. The sailors keep testing it and find it's getting shallower. They don't have a clue where they are, but they know they're headed for trouble. No one in this room would ever do this, but the Bible sailors jump in the boat and they want to clear off. But St. Paul knows the value of seamen, and so he says to the soldiers with him, if you don't have these sailors in the boat, we're lost. So we hear of those who allow fear to rule their lives, and those others whose lives were ruled by trust and by faith. Because the mystery of the sea causes your character to emerge. Some of the people I knew in Whitley Bay in my very first job, some of those sailors who had spent decades out to sea and then back home, some of their families, had an extraordinary strength in the face of whatever life could throw at them because of what they had learned from the world. Steady character, something not to be overturned by the ups and downs of life. Something to give as a gift to the wider nation and to the wider West. Because as we know, people normally can get away without any sense of the strength and the power of nature. They can live without respect for the created world, but for you, friends, that would be a foolish way to live. So you have lessons to teach, and we ignore your lessons at our peril. Today we honour and celebrate the contribution of the merchant navy to the life of the world. We honour and celebrate all that you do, and all that your friends do, and all that those on the sea now do to sustain our way of life, to feed us and provide for us, and quietly to build the platform of our civilization. We also honour and celebrate what you do to to give us a careful and a watchful and a respectful attitude to the word God made, which is so much more than a toy for us to control. In the Bible days, they knew this better than we. And that's why hundreds of years before St. Paul in the Old Testament of the Bible, the writers of the Psalms understood what it was to put your life at risk on the waters. And I read to you now from Psalm 77 that those of you here who are seamen or retired, you may remember something of what this is like, even over thousands of years between when it was written and now. When the waters saw you, O God, they were afraid, even the deep trembled. The clouds poured out water. The skies gave forth thunder. Your arrows flashed on every side. The crash of your thunder was in the whirlwind. Your lightnings lighted up the world. The earth trembled and shook. Your way, God, was through the sea. Your path through the great waters. And your footsteps were unseen. In the storm there is a path. Steps are unseen. To live in such a world, even with all the technology we have today, you must have resources of character. You must be a person of confidence. And whether or not you're a Christian, you must be a person of faith. It is this calm and respectful understanding of the world that marks the sailors I knew as a young priest, and have known since, that marks so many of you. When you're at sea, you know the horizon. The curve of the world gives you a long perspective, but you know that you cannot see forever. In this too, you have much to teach us. We can see far, but not infinitely far. There is a mystery. Bible story where sight fails and they have nothing left but faith. That's when St. Paul breaks the bread and gives it to them to eat so that they may be encouraged. And so today, we in the landlord's world, we who are fed by you, we give you our thanks and our own encouragement. Thank you for setting out on the waters, still the trackless waters. Thank you for all that you bring back for us. Thank you most of all for your character in the face of the world as it is. And friends, be encouraged. We recognize the life you have chosen. We honor you for your courage.